Okay, are we started? wonderful. Welcome to Spiritworks Distillery. My name is Lauren Patz, and I've been working here for almost, I guess, 2.5, 3 years.
Well, my name is Timo Marshall. Who I am, I don't know, that's a tricky question. along with Ashby, my wife, we built this distillery. And what do I do here? It changes every hour. I don't really know what I do here. I do a million things.
I came to Spiritworks as the tasting room manager and an apprentice distiller. So because the company is so small, it's definitely one of those situations of wearing many hats. And once I got a taste of that production lifestyle, I couldn't let it go. I was like, I gotta burrow my way in there. One of the fun things about working at a distillery or, you know, working at any sort of production facility making things is really that you get a chance to be creative. And so one of the experiments that we've had a lot of fun with is hooking up music to barrels.
The music barrels. When I started learning more about maturation, and about what happens in a barrel, the interaction between the whiskey in a barrel and the wood itself, and all the different components between the two, I realized that the most important part of that was the interaction, the point where the liquid touches the wood or where they interact. I attached a couple of speakers to the back of a barrel and started playing it music.
So the idea behind it is that during that maturation process where the whiskey is moving in and out of that wood, we are trying to enhance that through vibration. So as that music is playing into the wood, it's vibrating and allowing for more absorption and exhalation in and out of that wood, in and out of that barrel. When we're choosing our music, we really want to get a wide selection of options so that we can see the range that we're able to achieve in terms of results. So we've got some classical, we've got some heavy metal, we've got some electronica and punk. And it's going to be really fun to open those up in a couple years' time and taste how they taste.
I have no idea where the idea came from. I mean, at the end of the day, everything is about, you can't create like tangible things like spirits, like ultra premium products, unless there is a mixture between art and kind of science and logic kind of thing. And so I like to think that Ashby and I complement each other very well in that way.
One of the things that I did to kind of make that process even more fun, I mean, if you can imagine something being more fun than drinking various proofs of whiskey, was I pulled some samples from one of our whiskey music experiments. So one barrel being hooked up to music and then its control barrel, which hadn't been. So I pulled samples from both of those and just popping off the top, popping that bung out, I could smell the difference between them. It was like really? An instant wave of smell, and they were totally, totally different.
No, for every music barrel that we have a control barrel as well. It's the same batch, same age, same everything. We barreled it on the same day, etc. Except one listens to music and one doesn't. I'm sure that there's going to be a difference between the different music between the barrels as well, just because of the type of, not necessarily the vibes of the music, but just because of the type of music it is. If it's very different, if it's very light music, as if it has a lot of bass.
Right.
I feel there's going to be a difference, yeah. Yeah, I think we'll bottle them. I mean, we'll obviously bottle them all separately. Those will be single barrel projects. Yeah, I think it's going to be really interesting when the time comes to see, and also to see when they're ready. Some of them may be, because of the music, some of them may end up being ready sooner rather than later. But yeah, I think there's definitely going to be a difference between them all. I mean, we've done some preliminary tasting already, and there's definitely a difference between the music barrels and the control barrels. It's difficult to say how much of that difference is still going to become apparent once they come of age, but we'll see. We've got another year or so to go, so we'll see.